In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can generate random values from various distributions using Rguroo's random generator. Moreover, I will demonstrate how to apply predefined statistics to generate these values. From the probability simulation pane, select probability, then click on random generator. This generator allows you to create any number of random samples of the same size from the same distribution. By clicking on the distribution dropdown, you'll be able to select the random variable distribution and specify its parameters for which your sample is to be made. The sample size text box determines the size of the random sample. This will be the number of rows in the output table if no statistic is selected. The replications text box is the number of samples you want to create. This will be the number of columns in the output table if no statistic is selected. Let me give you an example of how the random generator works without the use of a statistic. Let's simulate three samples of size 500 from an exponential distribution with a rate of 2. From the distribution dropdown, select exponential. For rate, type the value 2. For the sample size, type the value 500. And for replications, type 3, since we want 3 samples. Now every time you run the random generator, samples are going to vary. To reproduce the same results, you would need a set of seed. If you would like to be hands-on and duplicate the exact demonstrations in this video, set your seed value to one of my favorite numbers, 22. Now scroll over and hit the preview icon. In the output table, the three columns labeled sample 1, sample 2, and sample 3 are the three samples of size 500 from the exponential distribution. Now the random generator can be useful to show sampling distributions for various statistics. For example, we can demonstrate a sampling distribution of the sample mean, and in particular, the central limit theorem. I would like to generate some values from the exponential distribution to demonstrate the central limit theorem in action. Scroll over and click on the Simulate button. This will reopen the Random Generator dialog box. Let's continue to work with an exponential random variable with a rate of 2. But this time, we are going to change the sample size to 50 and change the number of replications to 1,000. The Statistic dropdown allows you to apply one or more of the following statistics to each randomly generated sample. Here is a table that will give you a brief description of each of the predetermined statistics you can choose from. Let's go ahead and click on the mean and median checkboxes. Now it's time to see our results. Scroll up and hit the preview icon. This output shows the mean and median values for all 1,000 samples that we generated. Now to demonstrate the central limit theorem in action, I'm going to need to save this dataset to Rguroo. I'm going to title it CLT Demo. And now that I've saved this dataset, let's scroll over to the Plots toolbox on the left-hand pane, hit Create Plot, and then click on Histogram. Select the dataset CLT Demo, and for the variable, select Mean. To really hit home, I'm also going to overlay a normal density curve on top of our histogram by clicking the normal checkbox in the smoothing section. And finally, I'm going to title this plot Histogram of CLT. Now click the preview icon. This visual makes it very easy to see that the 1,000 sample means from an exponential distribution form a normal distribution. We have now shown the central limit theorem in action. To learn more about the different distribution parameters for a random generation, please reference Appendix A from our user guidebook. And if you would like further details and examples on how to use Rguroo's random generator, we also encourage you to reference the chapter Random Generation.